back for another Witcher series but completely lost the plot?
Where the bloody hell are we?
Not to worry, this is everything you need to know before Season 3 of The Witcher. Welcome to the continent, a land of prophecies, mages, monsters, more monsters, and witches. This one is called...
Geralt of Rivia.
Geralt meets this bard Yaskia and they become the best of friends and through magic falls in love with this sexy mage Yennefer. Right before Geralt opens his big mouth...
What did you just say?
Fuck.
...and breaks up the gang.
See you around, Geralt.
Geralt saves this porky-cursed man, Dooney, and Destiny binds himself to his daughter, Princess Cirilla of Sintra.
Fuck.
That's the spirit. Now she's all his responsibility.
Bullshit.
Years later, this big evil army of Nilfgaard seeks world domination and takes over Sintra, whilst their commander, Cahir, and their mage, Fringilla, look for Ciri.
The key to everything.
She manages to escape with some mad screaming powers, knocking over this monolith. She and Geralt eventually find each other and make their way to a place called Kaer Morhen. On the way, though, Geralt's man-pig friend tells them about...
A port of doom, the Wild Hunt.
Who will bring...
The end of days.
But Geralt's like, what shit does that smell of?
Oh, shit.
And they mosey onto Kaer Morhen. That's Geralt's father figure, Vesemir. He greets them with the rest of his adopted Witcher family.
Your home.
This one turns into a tree monster, almost killing everyone. And Geralt's like, better train Ciri up in case I die. Ooh, good luck with that. So, Taseya tells Geralt that his ex-girlfriend is dead after having saved the continent from Nilfgaard by Hadoukening them with illegal fire magic. What Taseya doesn't know is that Yennefer's actually alive, but has been captured by Fringilla. But then her gang is killed and they're captured by elves.
Fuck.
Elf leader Francesca and the gang are in hiding. Fringilla is like, I'll save you if you join forces with Nilfgaard and Sintra. Yennefer's left alone. And powerless. Oh yeah, she lost her magic in the fire. She's like, for fuck's sake! Not to worry though, Aretuza still loves me for saving everyone. She bowls in like, if you're happy to see your hero, clap your hands. Despite saving everyone, they figure she's a Nilfgaardian spy. What's the best way to prove that you're not a spy? Burn the place down, free the Nilfgaardian prisoner Cahir, who you were meant to kill,
come on then,
and make a nut-crushing run for it. Somewhere near Kaer Morhen, Ciri finds this fugly bug monster. Geralt invites his mage friend Triss to do some tests on the dead monsters, and they find monolith dust.
How did two different monsters wind up with the same dust on them?
Good question, Ciri. Geralt goes with Yennefer's other ex-boyfriend Istrid to the monolith that Ciri screamed down, and finds out she somehow opened a door to the other worlds.
Monsters. They're using our monoliths as gateways.
But to make matters worse, Vesemir discovers that, spoiler alert, Ciri might be the chosen one.
Only grows where elder blood has spilled.
And Ciri's like, oh, bloody elf. Triss is like,
no, no, no.
After finding out Ciri is prophesied to bring the end of days via the Wild Hunt. Sound familiar?
A drop of her blood could change the world. She will destroy it.
Geralt and Ciri head over to this temple for peace and guidance.
You are entirely fucked.
On the way, though, a monolith monster appears and takes out Roach. Remember the tribute? Nice. Geralt goes all angry eyes and does his thing, followed by an epic hero line.
Where the fuck are my swords?
Elsewhere, Yaskia helps fugitives Yennefer and Cahir, but is captured by this fire mage dude, who Yennefer does a spit take on.
Who the fuck was that?
He's a criminal mage hired by this woman, Lydia, to find Ciri. Yennefer, totally oblivious of Ciri, later makes a deal with a demon witch.
I want to make a trade.
To bring her Ciri in exchange for her powers back. She finds her at the temple, but then, oh, as if by magic, she finds Geralt too. Yennefer's like,
is this possible?
It's magic.
I don't care.
All right, whatever. So just as they're getting acquainted with a bit of Yennefer BS, Fire Dude shows up.
Firefucker.
That works too. Whilst they have a massive fight, Yennefer teaches Ciri how to portal.
Wonder question!
Yen, stop.
And fucks off. Firefucker nabs a vial of Ciri's blood, takes it to Lydia, who gives herself an overbaked facelift. Cahir arrives in Sintra, where Francesca gives birth to an elder blood baby. But it doesn't last long, and they're hungry for revenge. And then they find out that Ciri is of elder blood.
She could save us.
Elsewhere, Geralt and Yaskia get back together. And whilst we realise Yaskia's vocal cords aren't the only muscles he's been working on, they realise Yennefer is working with the demon witch.
Bless me.
Meanwhile, after bonding with Ciri over magic, Yennefer realises she's being a bit of a dick.
I'm so sorry, Ciri.
But then they get attacked. Geralt saves the day and provokes Yennefer with a mean staring contest. Yennefer breaks first and takes him to the demon witch. But it's too late, she escapes, possesses Ciri, and kills a bunch of witches in Kaer Morhen. demon-possessed Ciri scream portals in these big Ember dino snakes.
What the fuck?
Just when all seems lost, Yennefer sacrifices herself for Ciri, but then Ciri portals them to the demon witch's world, who leaves Yennefer for her original body, part of the Wild Hunt. Sound familiar? And they're like,
your place is among us.
They portal back and Yennefer somehow regains her powers. Geralt's like, if anyone finds out about Ciri...
they won't stop coming for her.
But they already have. So, to sum up, the elves, the Brotherhood, the Northern Kingdoms, Firefucker, Zombie Chops, and the Wild Hunt are all looking for Ciri. And as for Nilfgaard, who wanted Ciri from the very beginning, well, their god leader, the White Flame Emir, is in fact the porky cursed man, Dooney! Ciri's father! Who could have seen that coming?
Shit.
So, yeah, basically everyone's fucked. But how? Find out in season 3.